Open for reseal store.
Do you know who's happy, Brian Windhorst? Gabrielle Union right now is a happy woman. You want to see what she tweeted? Huge thank you to the fans in Cleveland, always treating our family like gratitude, always love. And then there was the other tweet from her, I don't know if we have that up, where she was so excited. Woo, she tweeted. Look, I want to give you the background here. Dwayne Wade and Gabby have a house in Miami. They have worked on the house.
Convention center.
It is beautiful for 4 or 5 years. A lot of renovation to that house. They have children who were living with them in Chicago, but when the move was made to Cleveland, they knew this was probably not the longest term move, so the kids went back to Miami where they had grown up, and they were kind of commuting back and forth. Just over the weekend, Dwayne Wade was in Miami for his son's 16th birthday, so you could tell that there was still a lot of pull there to get them back. And obviously, while there was some tension with the organization when Dwayne left, time heals, man, and we've definitely seen both sides take a closer sort of, more just sort of like, hey, this could happen sometime in the near future. This is not a shock.
Couple of things here. One, Ty Lue was kind of looking at his lineups and thinking that maybe Dwayne's playing time would be reduced. Jetty Osman, who finally started playing last night a little bit, was eating away Dwayne's minutes. Ty even said after the game, I want to play Osman more. That was code for Dwayne's going to play less. So Dwayne's role was going to shrink. And something very interesting just happened here. The ice broke. The Cavs and the Heat had not done business since LeBron James signed and trade 2010, which was one of the most contentious negotiations, I can tell you. And they were able to finally, after 8 years, 7.5 years, they finally do business to send Dwayne Wade back home to Miami, which is his second home where he wanted to be.
Awesome. All right, Tracy, I want to put yourself in Dwayne Wade's shoes. What does it feel like now to be going back home?
I mean, I'm happy, you know. Coming out of a toxic situation, I know, you know, playing with my boy LeBron James was, you know, ideal for me when I left Chicago, but it didn't work out. I mean, it's just a toxic situation. But I'm going back home to a team that I get the potential to play in the playoffs, and I even might have the potential to play Cleveland in the playoffs. So this is where it all started for him. His legacy is left behind in Miami, and I'm excited for him to go back home and be with that crew.
I mean, I know we've all talked to Dwayne about this. Like, the idea that when he left there in the first place, I don't think he really wanted to leave. I think that...
No, he didn't.
You know, he went, and it was a pride issue, right? And I think he wanted to come back to Miami.
Well, it was the way it was handled. I mean,
the way it was handled and it was pride.
It was a fault. I think it was the way it was handled on both sides.
You give Tyler Johnson $50 million, and you don't want to give me that.
That's right. I was going to say.
But even this year, even when he was deciding whether to get a buyout in Chicago and come to Cleveland, he wanted to go to Miami. There was an idea. The idea was there a role for him in Miami? I don't know that there is one, but... At least he's back home.
But he earned playoff contention. He's going to be a member of that organization going forward. And let me say that he's still getting paid by the Bulls.
Yeah.
Night in, night out. Not to play.
It always makes it easy.